It is incredible here. My gosh, I don't know if a week is going to be long enough. I will have to come back.
Last night.
Good morning, guys. So today I am waking up in beautiful Edinburgh. It is a lovely day. It's not too cold yet. It was freezing cold last night, but it looks like it's going to be a blue sky day, which is nice. And I'm just heading to Glasgow to meet Blair. That is about it for now. So I had a coffee and I had some nice breakfast, and now I'm going to jump on the train, get to Glasgow, explore there, and then come back to beautiful Edinburgh for 4 days and see what it has to offer. So I'll see you there.
And I wore my crown like a liar's soul.
I was walking to the train station, and as you do, I kind of got lost because everything was so pretty and I was looking at it and I wasn't looking at the street signs. But seriously, my goodness, look at these buildings. Like, I'm gonna have to turn my camera around to show you properly, but that's what happens when things are pretty. You get really lost because you just actually don't really look where you're going anymore. It is incredible here. My gosh, I don't know if a week is going to be long enough. I will have to come back.
Then pointed at my blackened heart and with a broken voice then spoke. Said plans are only wrecking balls, then life gets on its way.
Hey guys, so I actually finally made it onto the train. I definitely got a little bit lost coming here, but everything was so pretty it was hard not to get distracted. I think it's about an hour to Glasgow, and yeah, I'm just so excited to see everything in Scotland. When I travel, I know that when I get to a certain place, it doesn't take me long to figure out if I really like it, and so far I am in love with Scotland. So yeah, let's just wait and see, but I can't wait to see all of the sights, and that's about it. I'm gonna stop talking because people are gonna think I'm crazy. Okay.
Shadows in the market, where as a child I have once played. Every moment crashing through my mind, cold like the wind. Whistles down the promenade where my love and I have been. No countenance, no reason for the things I may have done. Now, stripped and standing naked.
Where are we?
Sucky Hawk Street in Glasgow.
Yeah, what's the busiest street?
Oh, come on.
Yeah.
So these strange days.
Hello.
Hey, we're in Edinburgh today.
Yeah.
We're waiting to do a walking tour.
We are.
We didn't at all miss the first one.
Yeah, we missed the first one, but then we had breakfast in the church.
We did.
That was really cool. And I got this cool beanie. And I think it might rain today.
It is raining. Thank you.
And yesterday we saw Glasgow, and that was really cool. Blair was an incredible tour guide. See ya.
Yeah. See the castle later?
Yeah, we'll see the castle later. And we're going to do a 2.5 hour walking tour, so that should be pretty good. And have a sit down and maybe see some music. And that is the plan so far.
The plan.
Yeah.
Take me high above the ground, up above the city lights. It's better this way round, and please don't let me down. I'm closer than I've ever been, I believe it's coming now.
There's a bunch of clues scattered around that lead us to J.K. Rowling's Harry Potter. Potter Row is the street where the University Student Union building stands.
She's
Victoria Street is said to have inspired Diagon Alley, you'll see that in a bit. The story of Half Hang at Maggie Dixon, some people say, is a little bit reminiscent of Nearly Headless Nick. The best clue is the graveyard, the gravestones in this graveyard, however. If you look to your left, you'll see William McGonagall. This guy was a notoriously bad poet. Please look up his poetry, it's awful. But J.K. Rowling dedicated a character to him in the novel. There's a few other names that you'll recognise in the graveyard. Peter Pettigrew, Lewis Moody, like Mad-Eyed Moody. Also Thomas Riddle, Lord Voldemort himself, is here in the graveyard.
Never come back down. Hey guys, so I have officially made it to my last day in Edinburgh. I've had such an incredible time. I did a free walking tour. I got shown around by my lovely friend Blair. And I've truly fallen in love with Scotland. 100%. There's so much history and there's so much charm to this place, and it's kind of been raining most days, but that hasn't bothered me at all. I actually kind of like it. I think it adds a little bit to the atmosphere. This morning, I don't know what I'm going to do. I just wanted to get up and get going because there's still a little bit of stuff I haven't seen yet. So I thought I would do that today. And I'm just on the Royal Mile, which is where I've been for most of my time in Scotland. But even there's lots of really cool stores around, and I just love every single building is so completely beautiful and different. So I think I'm going to have my last little explore, and then I've got to get all my stuff. I've got to walk to the bus station, get on a bus for 10 hours back to London, so it's a massive trip. But I've had such a brilliant time, so I just wanted to let you all know that Scotland is lovely, and if you ever have the chance, you should definitely go here. So I have made it to the bus station now, the lovely mega bus, which is going to take me on a 10-hour ride back to London. I thought this would be a good place to end this vlog. I absolutely loved Edinburgh and I'll definitely be coming back. But when I get back to London this week, I'm actually starting a new job and I found myself a place in the city, which is quite exciting. So I'm sure to start filming again for you guys and share some of those adventures and new stories with you. But I hope you have a really lovely day, whatever it is you're up to, and I will see you guys very soon. So see you later.
When I felt her heart, is when I felt at home.